Oh. That's good that you try. I get trying not to stop, Anna, but, even so, taking a break, yeah, is always a good thing. You don't burn fast. Yeah. Hello, everyone. Happy Friday. I apologize that I haven't, now yet? You're still an ad? But yeah, no, good thing that at least you are take you did take you do take a break when you talk. long days can wear on you too long. Like I get wanting the money, but still gotta keep it balanced. But yeah, happy Friday, everyone. I apologize for not in or streaming earlier this week. I basically developed sort of like migraine that was also having sensitive to light or brighter lights, so it would have been a bit difficult to try to stream with a migraine. I was like sensitive when I have lights. Night nurse comes in, we're gonna be playing Uno to one. Jeez. I mean, do you like add extra stuff for your Uno games? You know, or do you just stick to like the rule? Whatever. Like the basic rule that, you know, are written down. I haven't played Uno in a while. At least not like with actual cards, personal people. But I know when I did, we had quite some, you know, added rules. Cause that's mostly how I played Uno with friends growing up. Extra rules that, you know, we threw in because, let's face it, after a while, the basic stuff kind of gets a little boring. Yeah. So, extra stuff. So, like, stacks. We're going down. Every night, first, go to bed about midnight, 11 o'clock, because kids school. No school tomorrow. Play long and have fun. That makes sense. It's the weekend. I don't blame you at all. I do not blame you at all. Man, I grew up playing friends. We were doing stacks, so put down like a whole group of like up and down. If a draw two was put down, if the person that was supposed to draw two had a draw two, they could add to it and then make the next person draw four and go on. Next thing you know, you got people pulling like 10 cards because it's gone all the way around. Or, obviously similar with draw fours, where you put a draw four down, the next person adds it, then it becomes a draw eight. And yeah. And then, of course, like, elimination. Or, not really elimination. Like, one, you step, you got out. And the game just kept going. Did that when we played online. It was on the road. That was, yeah, no, makes sense. I keep forgetting about that, online. I haven't done that in a while. I think the last time I played Uno, in person with people, like the actual physical cards. Was out with friends, like friends and colleagues, because it was a mix. Those friends were also colleagues. And we went to Bar Louie. So I think both Bar Louie locations. And so while we were waiting for food, we just pulled out the Uno cards that we were playing. While we were getting our food and drink at the servers, at the waiter, or it was either waiter or waitress, server, regardless, just shocked. So, you know, like impressed that we just pulled out the cards and started playing. About getting Uno attacked. That's that newer set that they just released, isn't it? Am I wrong? I don't know. I know there was some set recently released. But besides migraines and working, no one has a machine that. Oh, that one. Okay, because I know there was a new that they just released that has like two. But just that. But yeah, between work, dealing with the migraine, and getting my dress actually done. Like, it's not done, but it's a lot closer. So, yeah, I'd say if I'm lucky enough and get enough timing, maybe by, like, I don't know, end of next week, I could actually start, like, really putting the pieces together, sewing stuff together. So, yeah, we'll see. Granted, I know some of the time I'll, because, Halloween. And Jibby's excited for to go trick-or-treat. That day, so, we're doing Sailor Moon and Sailor Chibi at her request. So, looking forward to that. Yeah, so, aim of the game is go see how far we can get through him. Which, think, like, along the lines of Stardew and Sunhaven, but instead of being a farm, it's a bathhouse with spirits. So, not into that, are we? That's always fun. Yeah, I clicked one scene and clicked another. Okay. Hey. Fortunately, my controller doesn't seem to want to work with it. It might be the controller it is. Yeah. First, there's no save. My first time playing. Speed of progress. Oh, that's always fun. There we go. I'm not playing like all keyboard controls all too often, but I think my controller wasn't properly organized well. Let me put that in. Oh. There it is. Turn it, huh? This bus indeed stops there. But you're in for a long ride. Best get comfortable. Here. Alright. No, I get it. Because, yeah, so it's not quite it. Which, I get it, again, the demo stuff. But I'm sure there'll be more when the time comes. Technically, no, but you have a choice. Oh, there we go. Here, that's a problem. Oh well. Please. Oh. Okay. Take a seat and let everybody else on the bus. I think it'll take 50 of these patrols. Fortunately. Let me know after stream. I feel there's like spirits involved, and it comes out like a little after your birthday. Like an official release is just a demo cat. Must be Rabbit. I'm glad you made it in one. My keyboard closer. I suppose proper introductions aren't. My name is Meek. I believe we spoke on the phone the other day. Welcome to Sans. Really quite lovely here. I do hope you'll enjoy the time. We received all of your luggage earlier today. I had my husband Quill help you get it. Fleet to the house. I'm afraid I may have sullied his first impression, as I had him carry the heavy. Speaking of, let me quit gasping and show you to your home. This way, please. Keyboard for me. Didn't quite get my controller set with the demo, but that could be any reason. Again, it's only demo. So. they should be better. Well, what do you think? Nice. I mean, I could go with the this is it, but... Oh, teasy. This is my home. Just remember the red roof if you ever need. See, either myself... I'm glad I didn't go with the this is it. Fine. That would have been very rude in that case. This here is my husband's bicycle shop. You might find it convenient to have a bicycle if you ever want to explore the nearby area. At the very least, a little exercise does the bike. Good. The fact that I just automatically put that third. Definitely had not. But then again, it wasn't that hard to figure out. Yeah. As you can see, this is pretty much the extent of our downtown. I'm sure it's nothing like the big city this month. But we've got everything we need. There's a restaurant if you're tired of cooking at home, karaoke bar, chicken restaurant, coffee shop, and Kenzo runs a convenience store a little way south. I could talk your ear off about all of the restaurants and how kind they all are. But Quill did warn me that you had a long trip to keep yapping to a minimum. And let the newbie. So let's get you home. Damn. She talk. Her husband had to give her that warning. And here we are. I do hope to meet all of your needs. Pictures I posted online were taken just last week. Who should all be back? Oh, one thing you might find different is that we tend to leave our doors open. We don't usually have any crime here, though there have been strange occurrences. And well, there aren't that many of us living in. What I'm trying and failing to say is that San Sate is very safe, and that I sincerely hope you enjoy the slice of the pie. Feel free to visit your neighbors where and whenever. Please. I know they'll be happy to get to know you. I'll leave you to it. I set up your futon this morning and you should have everything you need. I saw you had an old teapot in the cupboard. Maybe you can try out some of the locally grown tea. Okay, I'm leaving now because even I can tell I've nattered on. Good night. Honestly. Okay. Let's take a look. Oh, look, it's grandfather clock. Test interact. What interact? Been a long day. Interact beds go to sleep. Game is saved every time. Okay, fine. I get it. Go to bed. You wanna go to sleep? Not really. But y'all make me. Knock on the door. Ah, you must be right. Oh, don't look so surprised. Miko has already told me all about you. She's not really one to keep gossip to herself. Anyway, I'm Amelia, the other town granny. It's a pleasure to meet you. Town granny, man. Go to bed. You want to go to bed? Well, too bad. Go to bed. Basically. I came by because I wanted to welcome you to our little town and drop off. First off, in case you're hungry, you got the rice ball. That rice ball is from an old family recipe called rice ball from the convenience store. With a name like that, I'm quite sure it was, I don't believe it, homemade. You can eat that delicious morsel by pressing. It's great for restoring stamina. Why don't you set that down on the table there? Because I've got something else. Make me do that. Wonderful. Now this here is for me. You've got the mixed vegetables, eggs, egg and rice. You forgot to give it to you last time. You don't have to eat it now if you don't. Why don't you throw it in that backpack? But wait, that's not all. I saw someone say that on the television. What was his name? Billy Mays? OxyClean? Does rice, eggs, and vegetables well in a backpack? I mean, you've seen the stuff I apparently carry around in pockets when playing Wildflowers. Whole ass cakes, muffins. I was just trying to be flashy. I brought you a brochure of activities that you can do around Sparrow. Comes with a map, too. Which I'm sure you'll find useful. You think? That looks so much like a Pokemon map. And with all of that, you should be good. But, you're a writer, correct? It doesn't look like you've got a place to sit and work. Apparently 765 eggs in my bag. Thanks to AnScienceR. Did they take lessons from Bran? Because that also sounds like a very Bran thing to do. That really does sound like a Bran. I wonder if we might have something in storage over at the shop. My daughter's, but I help out every now and then. Why don't we head over there and see if she's got an old desk? Speaking of 14, Dosti, every time I give them something, they give me eggs, and I'm like, no, please stop. Time to go, drop some of those off in your, FC thing, desk. Surely there's room for that, right? Or, you know what? I know what you can do. Start finding sprouts and give them some. Like, start finding, like, people with the little sprout thing. Mail them. Don't you dare. I think I've put some in there. But yeah, no. Start giving them the sprouts. But yeah, speaking of, alright, I think the Fearless can be the owners of a shit ton of yeah. Honestly. Honestly. Speaking of Fearless, I'm not. Speaking of, I was gonna say, the All Saints week started today. I don't know if you got a chance to or not. This is just so exciting. You'll understand when you're an old fart like. I don't know, Dusty. Do you understand? shop is nice and close to your new home. Walk a little ways. Go. A couple more things. You can open and close your backpack by pressing. Take things out of your open backpack by pressing. Lastly, you can get around quicker by holding down left to run. Running uses up stamina. Covered by sleeping or eating. I mean, they're like, oh yeah, walk east. God, don't give me a compass. I need a flipping off. Where am I going? Where am I? I don't even know where I am on the map right now. Help me. Okay. Why is the map vibing? Cute though. I think I hear a song busy. Actually, I was supposed to be watching a shop. I snuck over here. All four reminds me of Mario Bros. Doesn't it? God. Let me go ask her if she's got a desk. Hey, you must be the newbie in town. I'm Moby. I run a coffee shop a little northwest. Coffee shop up there. Feel free to stop by for your caffeine fueled. Rabbit, it seems like we've got a desk here. Oh, Mo, you help Rabbit out and bring it over to their place? Yeah, sure thing. Thank you, dear. I'd better get back to running the shop, Rabbit. Don't worry about it. Just happy to see it be of use to someone. Phew, what a workout. Yeah, that looks like quite the workout. That's quite the desk. Where do you want this thing? Unless, of course, you like it sitting in the middle of your room. Move it to wherever you want using your house organizer. It's over there. Clean your front door. Oh. Okay. I can't move it yet. So it's stuck there. Oh, wait. No. There it goes. Okay. Ghosty, how dare you eat my rice ball? See that? Yeah. It, thank the god. I thought I was losing it for a second. I thought we were on an island, not like ancient Greece. But her. I was like, how dare. Listen, Rabbit, I'm not sure anyone mentioned it. Sherry Tate is kind of failed. Haunted. Seems legit. Like, Susan was telling me the other day that she's been hearing some strange noises outside her boat at night. And, in my own apartment, I've got these, like, weird plants growing around my bathroom. Yes, that's very true. I mean, yeah. Wait, I mean, I clean this tub all the time. Weird things shouldn't be growing out. Anyway, your food was just floating and then disappeared in front of me. Like, this place is. Wait, don't open it. It might be trying to bring its friends. Oh, wait. It could be trying to get out. Quickly, open it. Sorry to intrude. My name is Young. I run the temple at Southern Tibet. I wanted to be one of the first to welcome you. I hope that... Moby? Are you unwell? Young, so good to see you, buddy. All is well over here. Fire. How very curious. Anyway, Rabbit, like you haven't had much of a chance to explore the town and meet everyone yet, have you? I had a word with my associate, Jan, and she's agreed to help find and meet all of the locals. Jan, you know, she is a wonderful companion, and I think the two of you will get along swimming. She's waiting for you just outside whenever you're ready. Okay then, I guess I'll leave you to it, Rabbit. Be careful not to let Jan bite. Why should I be worrying about Jan biting? That's concerning. Don't worry about that. She's very kind. Enjoy your day. I will stop by later to pick up Jan once you familiarize yourself. She doesn't like to be away from her brother Maru. Game is safe. Ordinarily, the game will only save. Alright. Alrighty. No. This is Jan. I'm quite sure this is Jan. That explains why I, you know, got warned not to let her bite. That explains a lot. There's Bruce, Clarence, Eric, Faye, Gail, Jillian, Julian, Enzo, Kim, Leigh, Ling. Who apparently is another dog, which I really should see. Will, Song, Sora, Eugene, Tara, Toby, Yumi, a lot. Might as well go down the list. I feel like I'm following last. That's a good dog. Very good dog. You're a new face cat. Hey, I'm Bert. Why am I, like, slightly disappointed that Bruce is not dark hair, does not have dark hair? Why am I only slightly disappointed? Got any siblings? That's nice. Holidays and special events must be busy times. Not really. Hey, look. I'm trying to talk to you. I'm trying to talk to the dog. That's right. It's a good dog, though. Here too. Out here. The planet's around somewhere. I don't know how I feel. Oh, okay. Alrighty then. You must be the new resident of town. It's a pleasure to finally meet you. My name is Claire. Look, but why are you like freaking out? Wait. Hey. Definitely did not see that coming. No. Okay. That's Ling. Didn't expect to find Ling. New face in town, huh? My name's Ling. Be seeing you around. Okay. Hi, I don't think we've met. I'm great. How many other people are in here? The thing. Hi, you must be Rabbit. The whole town is talking about you. Oh, I'm you. I mean, these images are kind of cute for, like, to, like, represent everyone. Cute. Alright. I have to try Eric elsewhere because the dog is bad now. I'm fine. Okay, so you're just passing through. Got it. Hey, I'm Toad. I don't think we've met before. Obviously not. Honestly, I think I would have been weirded out if I actually found somebody after all at the same time. Yep. There you are. There you go. You must be Rabbit. I'm Faye, the local carpenter blacksmith all around. Hey, she looks cute. My family has been in the construction business for generations. I guess I didn't really have much of a choice. No, Eric's not here. That's why the dog. Alright. Hey, you just moved into that place by the water? Oh, I'm Eric. You are new to town, huh? I'm Kenzo. I work at the only convenience store in town. I'm sure I'll see you during your snack. So, probably live with you too. I'm Gail. I work at the karaoke bar in town. Gail. Walking in everybody's homes. Who are you supposed to be? Me? I'm Julie. What do you do? Hey, Rude. You're new around here? I don't think I've met you before. My name's Jilly. Please see me. He's definitely like not as rude as Liam. Person's right here. Oh, you must be the new person in town. I'm Sora. Pleased to meet you. Hey dog, where did you go? Where did you go? I think I lost the dog again. Where did she go? I hate that they don't have her stop when you're not following. Yep. Nice. Now I have to. I don't see a sign of her on the map. At least I know now how to find her again. Here. Oh, right. Okay. Who is this free spirit wandering into our little town? Rabbit, is it? Then I'll be leaving. You must be the new kid in town. I'm Song, and this little mister here is Momo. Let you walk right on into everybody's living area. Two. Six more to go, huh? So you're the one Nico was talking about. Welcome and all that. Dude, they trust you with the bike shop? Rude. Oh, of course, Rash. Yeah, okay. Wonder I got. Oh, hey, I'm Suji. You must be the newbie in town. Oh, who is this beautiful beast I see? I'm Tara. I live at the pension down by the southeast turn beach. Those silver stars. Are you kidding it? Alright, the dog barks sound more like a thing. You do that. Ah. Dog is fast, man. Hi, so you're a new face in town, huh? I'm Tifa. I take care of the tea field in town. Oh, come see me tomorrow. I'll give you a free sample. I gotta wait till tomorrow. Okay. That's just the only other dog. Got it. You look like you both have had a long day. I hope your first impression of our little town has been a good one. Oh, that reminds me. Tifa wanted me to tell you to pick up some tea leaves from her tomorrow. Anyway, stop by the temple anyway. Dan, Maru, and I all enjoy visitors, and our doors are always open. Come on, Jan. Good night, Rabbit. I didn't even know fish, like, physically make that walk time. I know it looks comfy, but this is just the spirited gym. The spirity gym. Sorry, no more sleep. But, Nighteye, hello. How are you today? Doing good. Ah, there you are. As promised. Here. You got the fresh key. Many objects can be picked up, carried, and dropped. Use E when facing an object. Get up. Press it again to put it. An item can be each used or has some sort of function. You can perform this action by... Remember, if you have space in your backpack, you can store or carry objects by pressing. I like how physically demanding it is. It allows me to stuff my mouth with food without any guilt. It's a cute little relationship. Place the tea leaves in the teapot by facing the teapot directly. Okay. Want to add tea leaves this time. Okay. Alright. Add break starting in 2 minutes. Or less than a minute. You added tea leaves and water to the teapot. Seems to be heating up for now. You want to drink beer. He drank the spirit tea. I'm supposed to? Super creature. So selfish. Leaving. Yeah. Wait, can you see me? Can't. This is. I'm supposed to be guiding. How long was I? I can't believe that even I became a benevolent. This. Wait, who the heck are you? Anyway, doesn't matter. We've got problems. Wait, you live here now, don't you? This town is crawling with troublemakers. They're what's called law. Because humans have stopped worshipping, leaving offerings, or even thinking about them. Fortunately, I'm not as weak as those other people. So I nearly lost control. Anyway, you can call me Wanya. Since you appear to be somewhat spiritual, you're to help me get under control. Down here. What's with that? You didn't come here to mess about spirit. I get it. You mortals live short lives and fail each day with things. The truth is, we. Damn it! Are you really going to make me beg? There are already so many lost spirits who don't even remember who they were. They need your help. You'd be like a hero, though. You mortals like all heroes, don't you? Fine, I'll help you. That's more like it. I think I have a plan that just might work. But first, you need to see something. Let's head up the mountain. Look for the stairs at the eastern part of you laugh. How far? Huh. Oh, there we go. This is, well, used to be a bathhouse of spirits. They would come from far and wide to enjoy the purifying waters of the mountain. Spiritual people such as yourself used to look after the spirits from the bath. But it's not all for charity. Spirits would in turn offer some of the wealth they received from their shrines throughout the. But as you can see, the bathhouse has been abandoned. The last bathhouse keeper was a spunky girl. In fact, she used to live in the house you've just moved into. So I don't know how long she's been gone. Spirits need you to become the next keeper of the bath. Otherwise, they'll become more and more lost and cause more and more havoc to people. I mean, don't kid yourself. It didn't have to. Anyone with a lick of spirituality would have done. But you did. And you can help everyone. Spirit for a life. So you're in it. Good. Glad we're all on the same. Then, we're meaning to get the place up and running. We'll need to first open her up. I'm not mistaken, I left the key with a spirit who has a fondness for find the spirit, and we'll find the key. Whether or not you'll be able to see the spirit is special. But we can deal with that. For now, let's head to a place with a lot of and it's probably the Venus sword. Try using your spirit vision. Ancient teapot in your house uses regular tea with spiritual properties. Use interest in your spirit. Hey, not bad, mortal. You seem to be figuring it out pretty quick. Ahem. Now then, find the spirit. No, that one. I haven't tried the one with caramel yet. Ooh, that one is so good. Hey, check out this mortal. They almost look like they're watching. I knew I'd be able to find you, but I thought with my stomach like you always. It's the fun! Let's cheese it! What the? Well, alrighty then. What in the world? Don't just stand there. Catch them. I'll use what little power I have. Keep your spirit intact. Buzz, right? Normally, using spirit vision causes your spirit gauge on the right to gradually. However, in this case, Wan Yin is helping you by preventing. Under normal circumstances, drinking spirits he made in the old pot and sleep for replenishment. Practicing LeBron Lala has gotten better. That's tricky trying to do it on keyboard, man. What are you doing, you lunatic? We just want to talk. Are you kidding me? Ah. Yeah. Better hope we don't get it now. You've gone and ticked me off. Play Brawlhalla. I forgot all about that. One time's over, clown car. Revert back now. What the hell is wrong with you two? What? Who? Onion? And which one of you peanut brains has the key to the bathhouse? Key? Key? I remember. One and a key. This is kind of adorable. Wonder if you better start talking. With that. Petra. You'll have to like catch me on Brawlhalla. I barely watched when I was playing. I have the key. I remember now. I'm called Father Oz, and I was known as Farah. They look like aliens from the Men in Black. I'll be honest. Vanya! Oh, I'm so sorry I failed my life. It seems I forgot who I was. Angry lady who likes to punch all the things. Isn't that the whole thing of Brawlhalla? Is all the characters like to punch all the things? Or I'm like forms? Why? Why are you trying to traumatize me on my own stream, Ghosty? How dare? Trust me. I've kept the key safe all the time. Here. You must be the new keeper of them. Got the back house key. Ability connected. See, so PTSD. Fearless leader, hi. I was wondering if you were gonna say anything else. But you seriously have PTSD from that game? Really? Why were you holding it up like that? Can't everyone act normal for just a moment? See? For you two, this mortal here, named Rabbit, correct? Has agreed to get the bathhouse up and running again. I expect to see much of you and your kind there, Rick. Yes, of course, one answer. We'll be there. We're friends. We're friends, of course. Risking my life for the textbook. Jeez. Please be careful. As much as I appreciate you popping in, I prefer you be come home safe. Gods be damned. Those fools gave us the runaround. Yep, that's the cat tonight, eh? Well, whenever you're ready, let's head to the bathhouse on the mountain and see what condition. I gotta remember how to get back there. I definitely don't. Try safe, I'll have to break out a Ouija board, summon you back and let Rabbit. Don't you dare you. Don't you dare. I have a way to summon you back if I have. But you will not bring that. Boo. What do you mean, boo? What am I gonna do? Yes, this brings back memories. You have no idea how important this place is, Rabbit. Spirits around here are in bad Cinco. Ha! Very funny. Probably can't see most of them just yet. Believe me when I say they're up to no good. Solemnly swear I'm up to no good. And that's my job. Fortunately, it's the townsfolk who are stuck. Hey, who put those happy thoughts in mind? Happy about that. There's just nothing happy about that. Then how about we start doing that? First things first. Follow me. Okay. There we go. Welcome to the bathhouse. It was built centuries ago. Really, Jinx? First thing you do when you come on my desk is fart? How dare you? How dare you? Captain, I need you to get your hat. And you come up with food breath too? Really, Jinx? Really? Really? Welcome to the bathhouse. It was built centuries ago and has served as a sanctuary for spirits ever since. One thing you probably noticed is that you can see me without even using your spirit. It's not entirely known why spirits can be seen, but it likely has something to do with a very rare tree that was planted in the courtyard. Over time, the tree grew to enormous proportions and has exerted its special properties on it. Anyway, enough of the history. You're here to keep the bathhouse running and to guide our essential customers to their spot in the bath. Spirits will pay you depending on their bathing experience, which can be affected by anything. I don't want to look at that. Including, follow me. Okay. Including water temperature. This is the boiler for all of the bath. But you have to keep this thing burning so the bath can stay hot. Food breath and no henshin brush still. Magical girl, cat is broken. That's because this is more familiar, witchy familiar cat than magical girl cat. And cat, what did you do? Yeesh. Leave the mouse alone. Your source of fuel for this baby is right here. Cut a chunk of this tree root fuel. It works perfectly fine. It's a good work. Oh, I'm facing the sod. Okay. Ready. And voila! The tree magically regrows its fruit. I'm sure the tree doesn't like you doing it. But bathhouse keepers cut the same root over and over for some time. And this is just a hunch, but it seems like the tree is doing. Yeah. And one thing to note is that this root's ability to regrow depends on the spiritual presence of the boy. What I mean is, the more spirits we track down and smack sense, the more healthy the spirit tree becomes. Which means more roots regrowing and therefore more movement. If you don't see the root regrowing, then you'll probably have to wait. I'm sure it'll be growing again after the flip. Anyway, throw that log in one more into the boiler and then come eat. No. Being a terror. Good work. I'm glad to see you can follow simple instructions. With your work ethic and my brain, you can have this place running in no time. I'm kind of insulted by that. Maybe. Making lots and lots of moonlight. Anyway, you see the shrine. He shows you the bathroom. See the temperature dropping, then you better head to the boiler. Good. Now it's almost time to ring the bell and let the spirit. First, we need to make sure we've got some clean towels to let the spirit. Spirits need towel. Of course they need towel. What kind of a shoddy bathhouse are you planning on running here? Come on, let's see if there are any towels still. If we're lucky, they won't be too moldy. Check that towel box for dirty used towels. When spirits are done with their baths, they will leave their towels in the box on their way out the door. You might have guessed, these two are facing the towel. Good, there's some towels left. Let's go get them cleaned up. Wait. That whole giant stack and it just passes under here like nothing. Like, oh yeah, let's go get them cleaned up. There we go. Welcome to the Washington kitchen. I suppose we never did come up with it. Just call it the prep room. As you can see, things here have also become quite overgrown and unused. Fortunately, that's not the case for the washtub and heating. Throw the used towels into the washtub and give them a good scrub by holding them. Keep washing until you've cleaned at least four. Now take those wet towels and start changing them over. Remember, towels will only dry if you've got warm air flowing. If you're not burning any wood in the boiler, then the towels won't burn. Yet another reason to boil. Towels will take some time to dry, so it's important to be as efficient as possible. There are always things you can be doing while running the bathroom. Keeping the boiler hot, cleaning towels, cooking for spirits when you're tired of the area, scrubbing spirits with a brush. All of these things will affect the spirits' happiness and therefore affect how many more lives they will eat in one thing. Piece of cake, right? You're a lively one. I can almost smell the mulags. Right, let's bring those dry towels to the bathhouse. And you. You bring them. Oh, duh. Are they dry? No visible mold? Perfect. Drop them over on the screen. Spirits visit the bathhouse, they will automatically grab a towel and move out. Make sure you do your best to always have some fresh towels. Alright, I think we're ready. Ring this bell to open the bathhouse. Bathhouse and the last spirit. Right on time. Got your first guest. Take their towel from them and lead them to our only bath that is perfect. One thing to keep in mind, don't see the particular spirit, and always bring the towel back to you. spirit will leave on you. I don't recommend doing this often. Not if you want to make it play. But there will be times when the spirit is too large for your bath or might ruin the experience for you. In those cases, give them a boost and they'll come back. Anyway, grab this spirit towel and move. Happy face means their happiness is improved, whereas an angry face means their happiness is gone. Once you've seated a spirit in the bath, they're in there for the duration of the day. This means you can place the spirit next to a spirit they dislike, and you won't be making them. You could remedy this by making an extra effort to improve that spirit. Giving food, adding elixirs to the water. Or if you're busy, you can just accept the blunder. The most important thing to know about running a spirit bath is spirits all belong to a particular spirit. Spirits enjoy sitting near spirits from the feet. On the other hand, spirits dislike sitting near spirits. Must have peanut butter. Ease. Okay, how about this? If I recall correctly, two spirits be chased around town, break, and fall. So, you probably don't want to sit them near. Figuring out which spirits belong to the people will take a bit of trial and error. Wait, you might be able to consult the full spirit. But those have likely been very interesting. One other thing. I noticed that when the previous bathhouse keeper was here, I probably don't stay the night. The ancient tree that grew out of the courtyard of this bathhouse seems to react to how pleased spirits are when they leave after their bath. I've seen this tree grow as more and more spirits are having a feeling. Possible something important might happen when it grows closer. I don't know. I'm usually more focused on how much money the spirit has. If you're being honest. Hey, I'll leave you to figure out things on your own. Ring the bell again if you want to close the bath. Spirits will still pay you, but not as much as if you let them enjoy their bath. But yes. Tired, you can always go home and save whatever that. Oh, don't forget to collect your earnings from the money pot by the time you're done. positive. Already had. Welcome on in, Cheese Master Production. Like that was the end of the demo. Yeah. Overall, cute little game. Okay. So honestly, I probably will get the full thing. It's a demo, Ghosty. So, more likely, yeah, it was cute. And I figure I'll probably get the full thing after it comes out. Which will be, if I remember right, coming out November 13th. At least on Steam, sure. So, that's a game to look forward to getting. And once I get it, I definitely will play. ballet industry more, and actually have longer to go. Yeah. Yeah. On that note, go ahead and call it, and we'll see if we can find a mate. Well, that one. Ooh. Oh, it takes recently enough. We're gonna but I know who we have been to and Miss Opal Maid still going and they're celebrating their 3-year anniversary? Are we wrong? So, go ahead and our recalls. Again, everyone, in, and I will see you guys. Bye.